the Baron Backroom. I'm here with Paul Herlihy. This is Wired Women Wednesday, and we're here with Emmy Mathias, captain of the women's tennis team, all AMCC first team nominee, and recipient of the third AMCC title in the last 4 years. Emmy, it's good to have you here. What does it mean for you to be both a captain and a four-year letterman?
I love tennis, and I love playing for this school, so playing for 4 years has honestly been, like, a pleasure of mine. Does that make sense?
Made enough sense.
As the, since you're, like, a four-year letterman for varsity, would they use, like, what letter should they use? E for Emmy or C for Connor?
Well, maybe it stands for, the four letters, stand for Paul, if you will.
Okay, so you think you're going to get four different letters, P-A-U-L, for every year?
I believe so.
It's kind of egotistical.
Yeah.
It's not my name. It's my biggest fan. So I give back to my fans.
I don't remember telling you that I was your biggest fan, but...
So why did you first start playing tennis?
I started my freshman year of high school. They just needed a girl to play, and I lived within a bike ride of the courts. So I was recruited, if you will.
How far is a bike ride?
Bike ride? I would say...
Measured in, like, the number of bike lengths, not miles.
Oh, perfect.
If
okay.
You can do that.
Well, let me just take the number... Excuse me. I just wanted to... Let's see, it's about 16 blocks. Each block is 10 bike lengths, so 160 bike lengths.
Okay.
Minus right turns, which the bike length shortens, so 150.
Okay.
Give or take.
That's good.
That's fair. Why do you think you'll stop playing tennis?
Because I will no longer have a team to play for. You don't really get a team once you graduate.
That's fair.
Or I'll be too.
So I personally have never played tennis on a team, whereas you and John both have. Can you give us a physical demonstration, and all of our viewers who are also not as familiar with the sport of tennis, could you give us a physical demonstration of a forehand?
Would you like to play me?
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
Okay, perfect. This is your racket. This is my racket. Okay, so what you do is you're going to stand...
What am I doing? Am I just...
I think I'm going to demonstrate the forehand. You do the exact same thing.
Oh, like mirror you?
Yes,
okay.
But are you right-handed or left-handed?
I'm right-handed.
Okay, I'm also right-handed.
Okay.
So, flip that.
Okay.
So what you do is you're going to turn,
step. Okay.
So I've been taught four different ways by four different coaches on how to do a forehand.
Great.
So what I do is I hold the racket like this.
Like this.
This is a continental grip.
Yes, it is.
Very well. And then you bend your knees, make a little C, and then you follow through and catch it with this hand. That's pretty much it. That's all I know.
So you guys just finished up your season this past fall, correct?
I did, yes.
Wonderful. Could you give us three highlights of your season, but could you give us them in alphabetical order?
Okay.
Those are numbers.
Where do numbers fall before or after the alphabet?
They're not in the alphabet.
Okay. I think the top one would be winning.
You're going to start with a W?
I thought I'd take the challenge.
She's digging.
I'm a winner.
She's digging a grid.
All right.
So winning
conference
title.
Yep.
Second, we won 82 games, and we lost 0. Still, that's 1 point.
Mm-hmm.
So overall, we had a... I just really wish that you would have prepped me with these questions before so I could have done that.
That was a highlight of your season?
My highlight was yelling victory when we won. And also...
That's great.
Just coincidentally, the same thing that you yell when you hit a forehand.
Yes.
Yes.
Same thing. Same thing.
Is that three?
Final answer.
I would say that's three.
Good deal. The door's that way. We're done.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Leave the prop with us.
Yeah, please don't take it. This isn't our property, but thank you, Emmy.
Thank you.